Chicago tap water has been in the news lately for showing high levels of lead. But lead isn't the only problem with Chicago water. In this episode, we're going to take a closer look at the latest data on Chicago water and what it means for you. So how does lead get into the water? Lead leaches from pipes, plumbing, and fixtures. Chicago is an older city, so trace amounts of lead are to be expected, but the levels might surprise you. A citywide test program showed that roughly 10% of the taps sampled had lead levels of over 9 parts per billion. Even worse, an article from The Guardian reported on questionable sampling procedures that may have artificially suppressed the lead concentrations. This aside, 9 parts per billion of lead is 9 times higher than what the American Academy of Pediatrics is pushing for. More recently, a Chicago Tribune analysis showed that tap water in 3 of every 10 homes sampled had lead concentrations above 5 parts per billion, the maximum allowed in bottled water by the U.S. Food and Drug Administration. The next thing to be aware of is chromium-6, an extremely toxic metal that is not currently regulated by the EPA. In recent years, Chicago tap water has averaged 190 parts per trillion for chromium-6. That's 9.5 times higher than the concentration determined to have a negligible impact on cancer risk. Last, Chicago is like many other municipalities. The water is injected with chlorine to protect against waterborne illness. While this isn't typically harmful on its own, many people find that removing chlorine from drinking water greatly enhances its taste and odor. The reason that we look so hard into these data is because the water filters that we sell in Chicago are actually optimized for Chicago's water. You can learn more about our water filters by visiting our website at hydroviv.com. Thanks so much for watching, and make sure to subscribe for important water quality alerts and helpful tips to improve your home's water. See you next time.